In a journey to discover my roots, I stumbled upon lost knowledge about water. I revived lost myths, stories, and beliefs, and found its inevitable bond with the feminine. Its ever-changing nature, taking the form of sirens, mermaids, and nymphs, disguising our ancestral fears and fight for survival. Let me tell you a few of the world's lost stories.
The soles of your feet are a window to your soul. They've seen all the lands you have walked, all the rivers you've crossed, every mountain you've climbed. They've tasted the mud that once swallowed you whole. They smelled the green, green grass upon which once you ran free. They remember. They remember, even if you have forgotten, how many times you fell and how many times you got back up. It's all written in wrinkles. Their wrinkles.
We were sitting by the sea, under the hot summer sun, with salt on our skin and hair, we breathed in what we called our freedom. Peaceful as always, she told me with a sigh. It seems like you have lost your roots. I remained silent, for she was right. I had indeed lost my roots. In the long silence that followed, I tried to remember the last time I felt rooted. Holding my breath, I waited for an answer that did not come. She whispered softly that her legs were her roots. That's why she belonged wherever she stood. Her words echoed in my mind again and again for a long time. Still, I walked this earth rootless, without a place for my soul to call home, until one day I heard my answer. A raindrop, and then another, and another. A symphony made of drips and drops. In the distance, the trembling of a thunder. And inside me, the voice of the sea echoed, waves like my breath rising and falling. I had found my roots at last. Water.
Γιατί ο γυαλός κάνει φουρτούνα. Και σε πάρει και
They say the water in fountains sleeps for an hour at night. During that time, a nymph comes out of the fountain and sits on top of it. Whoever wishes to drink has to wake the water up first with a stroke of their hand, or else the nymph is gonna drive them mad. At the edge of a cliff sat the beautiful Lorelei, combing her long golden hair with a gilded comb. There she sat and combed and sang, passing her time. Her song was so powerful, the passing by boatsmen, bewitched by her song, didn't see the jagged cliffs, nor the giant waves coming towards him. He met his fate underneath Lorelei's feet. And for that, Lorelei was to blame. The water in women's wombs brings life into this world. And with water, women clean the cooling bodies of the dead.